Welcome to Crate and Craft, and well, you know about that anyway, don't you? It's lovely to have your company, and you've joined us at a very, very busy morning. We've got it all sewn up this morning. Listen, seriously, it just flows. Yes, we have got one of your favourite shows that you wait for every single month. Yes, we're here with a sewing class extraordinaire. And by the end of it, you're going to learn some new stuff. You're going to learn how to do it, and you can do it yourself. But more than that, we're going to give you all the instructions as well, because this class you can find on our website, cratecraft.tv, a little bit later on. So it's not a memory game. You don't have to remember what everything's said. And also, there will be a fact sheet and a PDF that you can get for this as well. Now, what is it? Well, of course, it's... Jennie Rayment!
Hello,
my darling. How are you? Give me a kiss. Lovely to see you.
And you as
You're looking
well.
As gorgeous as ever.
Thank you kindly.
And here we are again, the Quilting Classroom.
Yes, part two of our BOM. That's Block of the Month.
Block of the Month.
Boom.
I should do the voiceover for that.
Right. Thank you.
Block of the Month.
That's right. And as you said, you just keep going.
You just keep going.
Right.
And go up and go down with your voice. And people listen. And then you go quiet.
That's right. And then they turn the volume up.
Yes,
and then you shout at them. And it's really loud. And you turn the volume down again.
Sounds like being at home.
Shall we
go? Okay.
Right.
Okay. Then
you got 10 minutes.
Okay. We're rambling.
Yes, I know.
And we did promise that we'd be down the counter in 10 minutes,
rambling,
so you can get on with your
right,
thing, and I'm going to have my shreddies.
Yes. Good.
Now,
other cereals do have some.
Don't start with that. We're an advertising channel. It's all nonsense. It's all a myth. It is a myth. Trust me. As long as you keep going about shreddies because you want shreddies all the time because you want them so much, you want someone to give them for free. That's when you get into trouble.
Right.
Yeah. Like when I got my new watch. Anyway. Right, let's start off because we've got lots of things in the show. We've got to get you to see these so you've got an opportunity to buy them so you can make your block of the month.
Like fabric.
And we'll talk first of all fabrics. And you'll notice on your screen straight away, hang on a second, there's FlexiPay. Starting the day off with FlexiPay.
Wow, that's that is
not,
good for
bit
the fabrics.
Cheeky, isn't it?
Yes,
because
it means you can bung everything in the sexy flexi basket.
You can, don't nick me lines. It's 362837. The multi-by 6 100% cotton fat quarters. Remember where you are. This includes 36 fat quarters. They're all 45 for 55. Now, I understand just before the show, you said there's enough material here
to make
today's BOM.
The quilt.
Remember, we did it last month, didn't
we? Yes, we did the top half. Now we're doing the middle third, and then we'll do the next one on Easter Sunday.
Right.
So three sections. And the fabric we have here will make the quilt. There'll be enough to bind it and...
Not just this section today, but the whole quilt.
The whole thing. And there will be enough to make the back.
Oh, right? My word.
And
look,
you
at this.
Will have some left over because you've got there 36 fat quarters. That's 9 yards of fabric for that minuscule price.
Right,
and it's
okay,
nice material.
So we got the fabric. So all the colours you're seeing up there on that wonderful quilt are right here with a $13.95 saving. And as Jennie quite rightly said when she nicked me line, you've got the opportunity to have a sexy flexi basket now. Too early? Yeah, too early. 362837. So bear that in mind, okay, with the fabric. Really, really soft and absolutely gorgeous.
Yep.
Now, let's talk about cutting shapes out because it's really, really important that you have all the tools for the job for this. And again, we've got another flexi pay offer for you this morning, guys, if you want to take advantage of this. A lot of triangles here, madam.
Right, and they all do different things, and we'll be using them. This is what's known as a companion angle. It's a quarter square triangle, and the nice thing about it, it's multi-sizes in quarter of an inch increments.
Right.
So you can get very, very good combination of sizes with that one.
Right, there's five in here, this one.
Then you've got the half square triangle, and
of course,
again, the
classic.
Same... quarter of an inch increments on there, and a nice handy size. So these two, the first two, are absolute patchwork classics. You've got to have them.
Right, we've got them then. We've got those, so we're happy.
Then we have the tri-tool, and that actually comes with the Rex tool because that's its other half. So that's a bit that goes there and indeed there to make the square.
Yep.
And this is a really useful template. It's not a 60-degree triangle, so don't think you can do it with that. It actually forms a square, and I'll show you later why it's so useful.
And with patchwork, we're always coming back to squares, aren't we?
Yes.
That's what we always come back
this
to.
One works in conjunction with this because you can use it to make... Let's get it round there.
I call them the fillers.
They are very good
fillers.
Do you know
what I mean? Got the main shape, and it's around. You don't think of the filler around the outside because you always see the main shape, but you forget that it's actually connected to something else to make a square.
I'm being challenged.
Morning.
Right, that's all right. Wake up now. This bit is the bit that goes here, which, if you see, will then convert it into being a rectangle.
Beautiful.
And can be used as a border. Can also be used to create an interesting shape in conjunction with the other. So this is for me a classic bundle of ideal shapes to have.
This is almost as must-have as our next item.
Yes.
That's what I'm going to say. 275992 is the item number, and again, it's on Flexi, so you'll need to pay half of it today, £22.50 if you're a club member, and if you're not a club member, pull your finger out and go and join.
Yep.
I'm just not missing about this morning. It's straight talking Sunday.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Right.
Okay,
I've got some straight talking to do later on. I want to see some people, I'll tell you. Right, let's move on to the
now
big bundle
now. You've got a
now.
Bigger half-square triangle. So this is the larger one. Again, works in the same way as the smaller one. It's just handy to have because it covers all sizes, right from 2.5 inches up to the big one. And if you're thinking, well, do I need them both? And the answer is yes, you actually do, because this one does smaller triangles as well. So this will do up to 2.5 inches and beyond, but that one starts at 2.5 and goes to 10.5.
Right.
So I use the two of them. You
right,
really can't have too many triangles.
Be very careful when you're asking the questions and answering them, OK?
Yes.
Right. No, because you go, why do I need that? Well, I do that. I ask questions and answer them myself because it's quicker. Right, look at this. I need. Look, I've got to pick up a piece of paper for this because this is a monster. This is nearly a 24-inch monster.
So have to have
I've got
one
of these at home. I've mentioned it before. 275327. Well, what can I say? It's the ruler
it's
you need.
It's the starter one. If you're going to be starting patchwork, you need a big ruler, you need a big square, you need a triangle, then you want the rotary cutter and the mat to go with. There are very many different ways of doing patchwork. I'm a rotary cutter fan because it's fast and it saves fabric, etc., etc. And because of that, I need one of those, and I also
bet you
need
do. The thing
this.
Is... Oh, hang on, I could have had a bigger piece of paper, couldn't I? I've been sliding up and down an
well,
A4.
You could indeed.
Oh, dear. Oh, now then.
And there is your big 12.5-inch square. Why is this so useful? It's because so many patchwork blocks in the patchwork world are 12.5 inches. So you just cut round it and you've got the right size square.
And it's fabulous to make sure that for things like curtains and that are square in the corners.
Quite. Because you can lay that one down, put this one beside it, and then you've got a nice long
one. Yeah, exactly.
So great bundle, must have.
We're not rushing, we are rushing. But we want to get through this because I want to make sure you see the lessons today. So if you want these, £51.99, down to £46.79 if you're a club member, but two flexes mean £23.40 actually. Now then, I mean, quickly on to this.
Now
tell
that's
us about this.
Very useful. If you don't know what to do with your templates and you like visual learning, this will take you through 9 different blocks. It uses Trirex bundle that we've done. It's got your quarter and your half square templates in there. It also brings in your 60 degree. You can make all the various different blocks with a series of templates. It's a very good visual
learning.
So if
you're buying templates today, buy this.
Yes.
If you don't know what
you're
doing.
It's me teaching you.
Do you know, when
you
say if you're
visual,
I don't think there's any other way.
No.
That's why there are apps and that's why there are pictures for everything because humans learn by pictures. That's why we have the eyes.
And you can start and finish it. Turn me off, but you can run through it time and time and time again.
Pause.
Absolutely.
The Rayman pause, we call it.
Pause. Right, then we have...
Moving on. You're not messing taking any prisoners this morning, are you?
No, definitely not. We've got to get the classroom on.
Right.
Yes. Right, now this is the drunkard's path and the 5-point star. We've actually only got the drunkard's path part here, but there is another part of this template called the 5-point star. So you get 2 bits in one.
Right.
So if we can just show the viewers what the 5-point star does, which is behind you.
Right, it's like panto. Go for it.
Go for it.
We got it, Chris, we got it for us.
Through the round window, and it's this one here. So your template bundle will make not only the 5-point star, but it will also do the drunkard's path.
Uh-oh.
And I will show you the drunkard's path because I've used it for the municipal gardens in the quilt.
Hang on, stay tuned. Hang on, is that the right one?
Yes.
It is, because we've got 2 bits missing. Haven't we?
Well, that's why I was...
26613. We'll move on. Right, okay then, because we've got all the bits.
Right,
well,
all
Sam's fought short of a picnic this morning.
Great selection
My
of
word,
bits
look
and
at
bobs.
This lot.
You have the bamboo poker.
Absolutely.
Great few points and things. Pencils. Wash out pencils.
This is a new kit, by the way. The Quilters Useful Tool Bundle, 281349, just I'm doing my job. 9 elements and 75 flower head pins as well for under £15.
Yeah, it's a good bundle. Invisible pen, masking tape, very good for marking seams. Your basting needles, these are great for curtains as well. These are great
to do with
long
chickens.
No, it's nothing to do with chickens at all. Tool handle. You stick this handle on the ruler, it will hold it in place.
Oh, clever.
Yep. Quarter of an inch ruler so that you can draw beside it and get exactly a quarter of an inch. And my favourite pins. Why are they my favourite? Because I'm doing it again, asking a question, answering it.
Because I highlighted it.
That's
now,
right, you have. Because they're nice and flat. You can put the ruler on the top. The ruler doesn't cockle when you're cutting anything. And, of course, you can see them when you drop them on the carpet. And if you have perhaps flexible issues with your hands, these are nice to hold because it's a nice big flat.
What I like about quilting is all intelligent tools.
Yes.
And everything that you use is intelligent and thought through, and it's common sense. Pins, the quarter-inch bar here. This little thing here, put the suction pads on, by the way, and it picks up your... You can put your little thing on. And it holds it. And you can hold it while you... Do you see what I mean? It's all intelligent stuff. Can't get it off. Leave it on. Right, if you want to get that, 281349. Let's go to the first of the books by this lovely lady standing next to me. The Tucks and Textures. She is like word smithery. Honestly, it's like Olympic, tongue Olympic. She's got to be very careful when she's here.
You do indeed.
My word.
Yes, don't get tired when you have some of my titles.
I won't. 275982. Tell us about this one quickly.
Right, OK. This has in it a whole variety of different things, ranging from dyeing to landscapes to a bit of folding and interlocking, but it's also got in it something called Corners on Log Cabin, which is an alternative to the snail trail we're using on the Block of the Month quilt. Lots and lots of stuff in that book, and it's got the famous, go towards the back, quick, keep on flicking, pilgrim script bag in it, which everybody absolutely loves. There is the pilgrim script bag, and of course it's got the pattern in it, so you don't want to have an extra pattern, it's all in the book.
In the book! At 13.49, talking of books, let's talk to the next one. So Simply Pineapple. What's pineapple then?
Pineapple is a particular patchwork, and it's one of the most difficult patchworks to do, but Karen has come up with a simple way of doing it, hence the reason for her title. And again, this is another option to the snail trail in the garden, because the snail trail is quite tricky. Oh, you don't
there
know
are
the snail
names,
trail.
Aren't
yes, there?
Are snail
names.
Trail. How
so
awful.
This is an easy way of doing it. And of course, if you have the pineapple book, then you just got to have her follow-on one, which is the Pineapple Plus, which we'll come to in a moment.
Right, there it goes. By Cairn, So Simple Pineapple. It's very simple. It's one's particular area, one particular discipline, and it's yours for £8.05 if you're a club member. Now, Pineapple Plus.
Yes, this is it taken a stage further.
Oh, my word.
Where she uses and brings in all your scraps. So if you've got lots of scraps, it's the same thing. It's
exactly
this
one.
The same design. Well, there you go.
This is the signed version.
And that indeed has, again, a lot of different ways of using this extremely simple technique of creating a wide variety of patterns using your scraps up.
Wow, that's great.
And again,
great.
It's back to sort of half squares and quarter squares and things like that.
But just take it step by step, isn't it? Can't guarantee yours will be signed, by the way, just so I've mentioned that. Lawyers are happy. Lawyers, oh, put the phone back down. Right, now then, what's different? Can I get the bit of paper again? Could you just grab the paper, darling? What's different to this one than I've just seen?
This is a pineapple ruler.
Oh, I see, so this goes
for,
well,
for those who want to do pineapple. Properly. Now, pineapple properly, let's go to this quilt again, is there. That's a proper pineapple.
Oh, wow, I can see what you mean.
And that ruler takes all the hard sums out of it and makes it easy.
Right.
We did this in a classroom about a year or so ago when we made the quag.
Right, okay then. So I always trip over those things. These, tuck the wheels in, boy, tuck the wheels in. I'm an old man. Now, 29042, it's like your dad, everyone, whenever you, when you get to a certain age, you notice it, when you go to trip, everyone goes like that. All the youth go, oh, bless him, and they put their arms out, like they're miles away, but they still put their arms out as if they're going to try and catch you.
I didn't try to catch you.
You didn't, I know, that's the sort of woman you are.
Right.
Oh, look at you on the floor bleeding.
Quite.
290422, get on with the show.
Quite.
Right, let's move on.
Fluff. Right, this amount of wadding here will fit the quilt.
Right,
it's
okay.
Super wadding, it drapes really nicely, it's a great price, and I just can't recommend this enough.
Okay, $7.19, 80% cotton, 20% poly. This is what you're going to need to sort of back your quilt.
Yep.
361332. People are buying ahead of time, you knew you needed this. So,
And we keep selling out of it, you see, so, you know, don't buy one, buy two, put it in your basket.
And then save on
P&P. Save on P&P.
There you go, see, right, doing our job. Well, something else,
Clever
we've
on.
Actually got the sellout section here. That always sells out, this always sells out. By the way, if you want one of these, buy it right now. As it's actually quite a pleasure to see it on the show.
Yes.
192527, the Clover Mini Iron 2 for perfect patchwork craft projects and applique. It's that tiny little iron that gets very, very hot, so be very, very careful with that. But if you're like, you like detail and you want to do it properly, you need the right
in
tools.
In the corners.
$35.99.
Right.
And finally, Dear Jane.
This is here because the Dear Jane, Dear Jenny quilt was being made. And just viewers, look, I haven't received the main bulk of them, but I have had some of the blocks to my house.
Oh, wow. These from viewers?
And yes, these have just been delivered to me. Thank you so much. I'm going to expect to get the rest of them on the 29th of March.
So the Dear Jane thing is all different bits made by different people, but put together by one person.
No, the Dear Jane is...
No, no, but this version.
Yes.
Stay with your version.
Same version. So it's a block out of this book. It's a block from any of my books. It must measure, like this one does, 5 inches from one side to the other. So you can have my techniques, you can have blocks out the book.
4.5 inches.
Finished. It'll be raw edge 5 inches to one side. Please keep on sending them. I'm collecting a load on
That's
the 29th
lovely,
of this
that
month.
One,
it's super.
It?
It's absolutely great.
Look at that one there.
Look at the ones they're doing. I'm keeping them in their bags because we're going to embroider the back of the quilt with all the names.
Do you know what? Fabulous. Keep those coming in. We'll give you more details out a little bit later on. And by the way, you can download the PDF of this particular project and second part of this project. There it's Quilting Classroom. That's what we're going to work on today, 21st of February 2016. That'll be today then. All the things you need, everything that Jennie's going to be doing. And so it's nothing left to say other than, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Jennie Rayment Quilting Classroom. And I'll see you after me shreddies.
Other cereals do exist. Right, morning,
Cocoa
everybody.
Cocoa Pops and Rice Krispies.
He needs his oats, just don't go up that one. Right, we're gathered together to do the second section of the Quilting Classroom. You may remember that last time, on the 10th of January, we did the top section. Now, you can still watch the video for this in the video lessons on the Quilting Classroom part of the website. There is the PDF for the one we're going to be downloading today. Now, before I begin, a very quick sorry to Mary that I'm not wearing your delightful little jacket that you did, but we couldn't make the microphone fit on it, so I will wear it another time. But thank you very much indeed, Mary Welding, for making me this absolute super crocheted little jacket. I really was delighted to receive it. Now, we're going to be starting off with the sort of lakes and sand. If I go to the quilt now, the bit we're dealing with is we're going to be dealing with this section, the sort of the lakes and the sand, for want of anything better, the deep dark forest, the little houses, the cosy cottages, the snail trails, and if you don't fancy doing a snail trail, you could do corners on log cabin, or you could do a pineapple, either from Karen's book or using the pineapple ruler. And then we'll come down to this section, which uses the Drunkard's Path template, and I'm calling the municipal gardens because they're all neat and tidy. The flowers and things I will come to in the next classroom, which we hope will be on the 28th of March, which will be Easter Sunday. So today's classroom is that bit to that bit. So starting off with the top section. Top section uses the Trimate. Now, the Trimate is a very useful template, and it works in conjunction with, let's find some white paper, it works in conjunction with the Trirex tools. If you were to use the Trimate and you used it in conjunction with the Trirex tools, you could get, and if we look at the blocks here behind me, this is the Trimate section used around just a simple star in the middle. The star can be made from your companion angle and your easy angle. Makes it a very simple block to do. Moving to this one, here again is your Trimate, and that's using the Trirex. It's a classic design called Storm at Sea. And one last thing to show you, down here we have the good old Trirex template used in its very famous block called 5440 Fight or Flight. And again with the Trimate round the edge. See how it makes it into an octagonal shape. Useful template, that one. Great for borders. So how are we going to use it? We're going to use it with a 3.5-inch strip. And I'm actually using the full size of the template. So in order to make the beach and the sea, you are going to need 3 of the full cut template, and I'm using the turquoise spot. So there was nothing more complex than literally cutting a strip and cutting out 3 of these in turquoise, exactly as I've got here. When you come to do the cutting out, you'll find you can save fabric because you can have one strip cut one way and the other one the other way, and they just literally interlock. So you cut one, t'other, and the next one. Let me show you with the orange stripey. So you're going to need 3 turquoise spot, and you'll want 2 of the orange. So I have a 3.5-inch strip, lay the template on it, pop it on there. You'll notice it's got slightly strange ends. That's meant to be. But the template will fit exactly a 3.5-inch strip. If you wanted a smaller one, you'd simply cut a relevant size of strip. Cut up one side, cut along the top. Rather than try and cut towards yourself from my point of view, because it's difficult, I can't get round the side of the cutting mat, I'm simply going to flip the fabric over, replace the template and cut the remaining 2 sides. So you're going to want 3 done using turquoise spot in this way, 2 done using the orange stripey. But we have to consider the ends of it. Because if you were to join all these together in one straight line, if I just lay them out like that, you can see, you've got a strange ending piece. Where's another one there? There we go. And we have to have a sort of end on it. And what I've done at the ends is I've used the orange stripey to make the beach. You could have turquoise either end, it doesn't really matter. So how do I make the ends of the strip? The ends of the strip have to be made with your piece of fabric folded in half. You must have a mirror image. And this is where you'll be using the other part of the template, the Tri-Rex one. And simply put the Tri-Rex template onto the orange stripe. And remember, we have it folded in half. Cut up one side, cut along the top. I'll just turn it round a little bit. That's a strange angle here. Cut along the top. And then there's a funny little piece on this template. There's a little tiny weeny bit missing in the corner. Little tiny weeny bit missing. It's because that will allow for your seam allowance. It's actually quite important. I've got to go and demonstrate this in Italy next week. So I should be saying molto importante, which is about the extent of my Italian. I can just about manage spaghetti as well, so that's about it. So I won't be talking much in Italy, which, as my husband said, will be a relief for the Italians. So by cutting off that little bit, that will help you when you come to piece it together. So to make our beach, you are going to want two bits of the orange, full template, three bits of turquoise and the two ends, and you're literally going to join them together to make one long strip. So that is the beach, nice and simple. Let's tackle the forests, and in the time-honoured way, I'm going to get rid of all this little lot and just chuck it on the floor. Then Dean can fall over it later. Right, moving on to the other half, to doing the deep dark forest. Now the deep dark forest will be using the Tri-Rex templates, and you can't be finding another piece of paper, these two. This is a tool that, as I said, usually makes or can be made to make this particular design. So here is your basic good old 5440 fight or flight. And what I particularly like about these templates is when you start to sew it together, because of the fact they're accurate, you just cut round and sew, you end up with a very nice seam allowance at the top of the pieces, and it does make life so easy when you come to put it together. Now, there's no reason why you can't just have the template and use it to make these blocks. But I was looking at the shape, and I thought, this shape could be used to make a tree. So why don't I use it to make a row of little trees? And the first time I used trees was, in fact, on the Christmas quilt we have here. And can you see the little trees running around the edge here? And incidentally, for those of you looking at it, the corners are done with the easy angle, and the middle pieces here are done with a companion angle. So you can see why that set of templates is so very useful. They all work together. So we've got the Tri-Rex one used here, the companion angle here, and your easy angle on the corners, in conjunction, of course, with regular squares. But how are we going to make the little trees? We're going to make the little trees by taking, in my case, the dark green spot, and also a selection of colours. Now, the trees I made literally from, I think, five or six different colours. You will want a 4.5-inch cut strip. And this is where, of course, having something like the long rulers does make life remarkably easy. So do get one of these rulers, and indeed one of the squares, because it does make your life considerably better. Having got your 4.5-inch strip, you're going to cut the trees out of it. Now, one of the nice things about these tools is they are multi-sizes. You don't need to have a variety of sizes. This one will do all sizes from 1.5 up to 6 inches. I've got a 4.5-inch strip. Lay the fabric out flat, put your template on the top, cut up one side. Don't try and cut towards yourself, simply flip it over and cut the other side. So that's going to give us one of the trees. And the trees are going to be joined together and linked together with green spot. Now you can laugh at what I did initially. I took one tree and two pieces of the green spot. And when you sew them together, it makes a very nice little block. And I thought, oh yes, I could take all these little blocks and put them together and make a long line, which I did initially. And then I looked at it and I thought, well, hey, come on. I'm joining two bits together, which is exactly the same shape as that. So why don't I replace that section with a whole piece, which meant I didn't have to do the seam. So I could take all my little trees and join them together with another one of those in between. Let's get that one the right way up. And that would make very easily a long line for me extremely quickly. So those became redundant. Oh, silly me. But, of course, you've got to have the corners and finish it off. So when you come to finish it off, this is where we're going to want the half sections again. And these have to be cut out by using your fabric folded in half. So take the fabric, fold it in half. In fact, I'll use that little bit because it's ready prepared for me. Pop your template on the edge, and we want this half for it. So let's put it on there, square the end off first. Just give myself a nice flat end to begin with. Take it off there, turn it round, and cut the shape out. And remember, it's 4.5 inches, so you use the 4.5 inch line on the template, pop it on there, cut up the side. Remember to cut the little bit off the top there that's molto importante. You will then join your strips together. So let's have a foreshortened one with just two trees and one bit in between. And one of those will go one end and one of those will go the other end. Now, if you were to take 9 trees and join them all together with 8 of these sections and the 2 endy bits, you're going to end up with something that looks a bit like this one. And here's my little row of trees all the way along. Now, it'd be really rather nice if your row of trees ended up measuring 36.5 inches, raw edge to raw edge. If it doesn't, you might need to put a bit of extra sort of sky on the end of the strip to make it the right length. Now, trees would be a bit silly if they didn't have some trunks. So I made the trunks up by cutting 1.5 inch squares of the relevant tree colour and strips of 1.5 inches wide. Now, the band works by having a strip of 2 inches cut at one end by 1.5 inches wide, then a tree stump, then a whole load, 8 of them in total, of 3.5 inch wide by 1.5 inch strips. And you put them all together to make a nice long band. And with luck, when you stitch it onto your trees, your band of trunks should fit, says she, crossing her fingers and praying for you all the way along. And the whole thing should measure, wait for it, 36.5 inches. So we've got our deep, dark forest done now. We've done the little bit for the beach, and we've got the deep, dark forest. And it'd be really rather nice, says she, hopefully, if the two strips were, my friends, the same length. If not, you might need to do a bit of jiggery-pokery. Incidentally, I have seen one of these quilts. Somebody showed me. I was in Tick Hill teaching, and somebody brought in, I think it was called Margaret, one that she'd started to make, and it was super. So I'm so hoping that you will be making this. So we've done the forest. We've got the sea and the lakes and the beach. What are we going to do now? The cosy cottages. The cosy cottages are, I'm afraid, a whole load of little pieces. So here we have one little cosy cottage. And I'm still working with that bundle, that template bundle that is the Tri-Rex, the companion angle, and the easy angle. This wonderful bundle. It really is such a super bundle. You know, you just can't be without it. Right, how we're going to do it is here's my little cosy cottage. And we've got the roof, which is your companion angle, your easy angle here, and then a whole load of little strips. In the PDF, it does give you the instructions as for exactly the right sizes. Let's deal with the roof first. Well, again, we're using 3.5 inch strips. So when using the 3.5 inch strips, I'm going to be using the blue stripey to make the sky. And this will take your easy angle template. And whether you're using the big one, the big 10.5 inch one, or this little one, it's irrelevant. They both work in the same way. To make the sky, you yet again have to have your fabric folded in half, simply because we want a mirror image. This is a 3.5 inch strip. Place the template on the top there, aligning the 3.5 inches there with the top of the strip. That little black bit will become apparent in a moment. Hand firmly on the template, guard off your cutter and cut up the side. Now, before you panic, when we look at the piece here, one end's got a nice pointy bit and one end is flat. Now, that's because this particular template will save you 3/8 of an inch on every single strip you cut. And believe you me, that can be a big saving. That little flat bit there really should have had a point on it, but the point you cut off, it's not necessary. Now, the reason for this little bit here means that when you come to cut out the next set, this time you simply turn the template over. The numbers are very carefully arranged on it, so when you turn it over, you can still read the numbers. And this time, your little black bit hangs off the bottom. So when you cut this section, you'll get, again, another set of triangles, just exactly the same, with a flat bit at the top and a pointy bottom. Nothing like a flat bit at the top and a pointy bottom. Now, the reason why you want to keep them in pairs is so that you can actually make the sky go. I like to have it long ways. The centre part of the roof comes from, again, a 3.5-inch strip. So we've made our sky. 3.5-inch strip. And now I'm going to use the companion angle because I want this to be a quarter square. And the reason why I want it to be a quarter square is so that I've got the grain running along the right side. I want my cut-out piece of roof to have a straight edge here. And it needs to have two stretchy sides here because that will go with my half-square triangles. You will see in a moment. So to make the roof, take your 3.5-inch strip, lay the template on top and simply cut up one side, cut down the other, as I've already done here. So there's the roof. Here are the two pieces of the sky, and keep them in their little sets because one piece of sky will go one side and one piece of sky will go the other side. If you muddle them up, you'll find you won't have the mirror image and you might have the sky going in different directions. But hey, come on, it could be a thunderstorm and you could have the sky going all over the place. And the reason for cutting these out, this now has a nice straight edge here and there, so it's a firm side to the block. The triangle has a stretchy side here, so that marries up with the stretchy side on that one, which means that when you sew the pieces together, they all flow nicely. And to make the roof, you simply stitch one piece onto one side, open it out, one piece onto the other side, open it out, and you will end up with a roof that looks a bit like this one. I'm afraid I'm a seams open and flat person, and I do think it reduces bulk. The choice is yours. I tend to feel for many patchwork seams open and flat. And of course, that is where the little clover iron is absolutely ace, and please don't do it on your cutting mat, for just pressing those little seams open and flat, because it can get into every nook and cranny. So bear that in mind. Right, the roof. Now, when it comes to doing the house, this is a whole load of little strips. It is on the PDF. You're going to need a 2-inch by 3-inch piece for the door, a 2-inch square for the window. All right, I hope you press record button or you're writing things frantically down, but you have got the PDF. You've then got, for the walls, you've got two pieces that are 3 inches long by 1 3/4 inches wide. You've got a bit that goes under the window, which is 1.5 by 2 inches wide. You've got a strip down here, which is 3 by 1. Then finally, you've got a strip that goes right along the top that is 1 inch by 6.5. And you may think, that lot will never fit that strip, but it will do when you take your seam allowances into consideration. How you're going to sew it together, I would suggest, is like this. You want to take one wall, one door, one strip, join it together. And you can see how much it's shrunk. So we've got a wall, a door and a strip. If you then take a window and stitch a window to the base of the window and to another piece of wall, we've got the two halves of the house. And when you join those bits together, amazingly, you will end up with a piece of fabric yay big. This should be exactly the same length, and thank goodness it is, as your 6.5-inch strip. So you can see how much you lose when you actually start to sew the bits together. Now, quite deliberately, on this piece of work, I've pushed the seams to one side. And the reason for that is I wanted the door to look as though the walls were in front of it. So the door was set in. Because when you press the seams to one side, you get a little ledge. And I want to have the little ledge so there's a tiny bit of shadow. And the same with the window. So the window is behind the walls. That was the reason for doing that. This strip, when you've made up, should fit your 6.5-inch piece. If it doesn't, you might have to cut a bit off, add a few walls, and perhaps have a rose bush or something going up the side. Once you've done that, then literally all you're going to do then is join the two pieces together. So you'll take your house base and the roof. With luck, the bits will fit exactly. Sew them together and you will have a little cosy cottage. Now, if you didn't like that arrangement of cosy cottages, you could always make something a little bit bigger. I mean, here we have sort of a grand house. And here again, you could use various templates to very simply create something a little bit bigger. But if you're working on the bomb, I'm using the block of the month quilt. I'm using these little cottages. So there's my cosy cottage. And in between the cosy cottages, we're going to want a garden. I'm awfully sorry, but I'm afraid you'll have to make three cosy cottages. Well, I made three cosy cottages. Now, you could, of course, always consider having six of them, if you liked the cottages, and just join them together to have a row of houses. You could always change the front doors and indeed change the windows. You could put curtains in. You could embroider things. Those of you with embroidery machines, how about little roses going up the door? How about a chimney pot and a few puffs of smoke? So opportunities for play are legion. Now, in between the cosy cottages, I decided to have some snail trails. So let's go to the snail trails. Now, the snail trail is a classic patchwork block. Here is a snail trail done a little larger. This is the basic snail trail done in two colours. If you were to take four of these, the opportunities for design and play are many and varied. So I could put them all together like that. And indeed, I could turn one round, just turn one round through 90 degrees, and you begin to change shapes completely. So it's a very good block for perhaps a border or just playing with colour. You could make the entire thing considerably larger if you wanted to and just go on, and there is a very much bigger snail trail. It is not the easiest of blocks to do because you've got to keep changing between half and quarter square triangles. I'll come to that in a moment. Which is why I thought I'll give you a get out for those of you who don't fancy doing a snail's trail. Now, I have a slight confession to make. On the instructions that you have for this time's PDF, let's see if I can find the right page, I'm afraid I made a tiny mistake. It's not a desperately difficult one, but if when you go to the snail trail, which is on this page here, and it will say, use easy angle, cut a 2.5-inch strip. I'm sorry, it should be a 2-inch strip. If you downloaded it from my website, it is correct. Well, it was as from yesterday. But if you're working from here, can you cross out the 0.5 inch? Because otherwise your little triangles would be too big. The picture is totally correct. And if I could count and I looked at the picture, I would have got it right. But when writing the instructions, you know, sometimes one's head is not always together. So we're going to take out the 0.5 inch there. Right, so how are you going to make it? The middle of the snail trail is made by taking 4 1-5/8-inch squares. Now, you might say that seems an awfully strange measurement. It has to work like this because I need the snail trail to end up as a 6.5-inch block, because we're working with 6-inch finished blocks, because three little houses will add up to 18, because they're all 6 inches when finished. So my three little gardens also need to be 6 inches. When it comes to cutting 1 5/8, these rulers do actually have marked on them the 1/8 of an inch. And if we go to here, here is your 1 5/8. So you can cut the sizes the correct size. I'm sorry, that is completely utterly wrong. It's 1 3/8. I really should read my own words. Let me just look at it. No, it's 1 5/8. I was right. When you've cut your little squares at 1 5/8, you're then going to join them together to make a small block. So join the four squares together, comme ça. You will then want a 2-inch strip. And the 2-inch strip will need to be in the same colours you've used in the centre here. So I'm using these four colours, the two green spots, the stripe and the plain green. So I've got four strips, 2 inches wide, in those colours. You're going to have to make three of them. 2 inches wide. From this 2-inch wide strip, you will use the easy angle and cut your little 2-inch triangles. So they will get cut off the end, all right, like that. How the block goes, taking these little triangles, you're going to stitch one little triangle to the relevant side of the snail trail. Now, my snail trail is going to go round clockwise. So my first triangle is going to go on there, linking to that. The second triangle will go on there, the third triangle will go on there, and the fourth triangle will go on the end there. When you've added, sorry, round the right way, that's it. Remember, this is all totally unrehearsed, literally done by the seat of my pants sometimes. When you stitch these four together, you're going to end up with something that looks a little bit like this. And it's at that stage where we change from using the easy angle to using the companion angle, because you're now going to cut four triangles, again from a 2-inch strip, that have to be done using the companion angle. I'm just wondering where I put my companion angle, which must have gone over here somewhere. And this all comes down to this having the grain of the triangles so that I've got straight edges. Look, straight edges to my block. These will have straight edges when I've attached them to here. So straight is going to straight. And you will then sew the four triangles to each of the four sides of the centre section. Once you've done that, it's going to end up looking something like this one. And now we need to go back to our easy angle one, and we're using a 3.5-inch strip. And you will cut 3.5-inch strip and using the triangles from the easy angle. All right, so we've swapped tools again. And the reason for that is I needed to end up with my block having nice straight edges, because the last thing you want to have is with any block is to have stretchy sides, because the block will then just misbehave itself like there's no tomorrow. Once you've sewn them on, you should end up with something that looks a little bit like this. Now, word of caution, snail trail is not difficult to do, providing you are careful with your cutting out. Snail trail is also not difficult to do, providing you are careful with the way round you do it. Because you may notice that these are slightly different, and I did not appreciate that these blocks are not quite the same. But does it matter? It's a garden, and no one would have their gardens exactly the same. So as far as I'm concerned, two people having their snails going round in one direction and one person is having their snail going round in the other direction. Now, if you thought, oh, I could never possibly cope with the snail trail, let's give you an option. And one of the options that I thought you might like to do is the something out of the Tucks and Texas 2 book. This is a design called Corners on Log Cabin. And Corners on Log Cabin is this particular chapter. And the sort of effect you're getting is the quilt we have on the wall, on the top there, over there, the rather soft bluey-grey one. It gives you a mock pineapple block. Now, when it comes to doing Corners on Log Cabin, it is not hard to do at all. I did it by taking a 2.5-inch cut square. Okay, so you can go for something very simple. You could divide this into little pieces if you want to, or you could just have a cut square. Strip round it with 1.5-inch, in my case, green dots. Then to make the corners on the cabin, if you cut 2-inch squares and fold them in half, you put one of these onto each of the four corners of my little block, which obligingly hides any hiccups I might have had with any seams. You then add another round of strips all the way round it, right the way round the entire thing. You add another round of squares, and this time you use 3-inch squares, and each time the squares are then tacked or basted in place. This will make a 6.5-inch block, which would replace, if you preferred, your snail trail. And of course, you have the option of rolling back these edges and catching them down for a bit of tactile something or other that you might happen to fancy in your garden. So if you don't like snail trail, try corners on the cabin. And if that doesn't, in that terrible expression, float your boat, and we'll come to boats in the next class, you could always look at Karen's book. Now, I brought Karen's book over with me, I thought. And Karen Hellerby does the So Simple Pineapple. And if you were to start off with her particular design, using 2 4-inch squares, one of them you draw lines on the back, you put one square on top of t'other, you sew all the way around the entire thing and cut it, and then keep on following her instructions, you will end up with a piece that will again make a 6.5-inch square. But you need to start off with a 4-inch one to begin with. I've done it for you. Should you inadvertently end up with them being a bit too small, hey, come on, add a border, put a path around the garden. So having dealt with our next row, which is our row of little cosy cottages, and let's go back to the quilt. We've got the three little cottages and the three little gardens. These on the quilt all go round the right way, but you could have one of each. Why not experiment? Why not play? And if you really didn't like it, just put a plain square there, because you could embroider something on it on top. And if when you stitch them all together, they don't add up to 36 and a half, well, add a bit of extra garden. Does it matter? It's a quilt. It's an original design. You are the maker. Right, now we're going to tackle the municipal gardens. And the municipal gardens, I'm using the clamshell and the drunkard's path template for. So let's get these all over here. This is a template that gives you four different pieces. It gives you the pieces that make up the actual drunkard's path part of the template, which is those two shapes. And then it gives you the pieces, which gives you the five-pointed star. If you looked at the beginning of the show, I showed you the picture of the five-pointed star on the quilt that we made. We have covered doing the five-pointed star in a quilting classroom. It could have been January last year. I'm not quite certain. You can, of course, watch all the old quilting classrooms on the website. But when it came to doing the Drunkard's Path template, which is one I really rather like, it can be nothing. So it can be as simple as literally cutting out an arc from the arc shape and an L shape from, amazingly, the L-shaped piece, and joining them together. And if you join them together, you will end up with a square. And obligingly, it is a 6.5-inch square, which is rather good, because it means it will fit. Now, you could just take these and just literally put them together as a row. And there you'd have your gardens, and you could just literally lay them out. If you didn't fancy having them on your quilt, it makes into quite an interesting square. For instance, it makes a circle. And I was playing around with it. I thought what you could do, because it's a circle, is you could actually use an idea that I often do, where you fold a square into a trumpet, and you could insert a trumpet between each of the seams. So you could get something different. And then I thought, well, you don't have to have a plain piece for that. Why couldn't I make my arc shape out of sections? Why couldn't I have it a little bit different so it's not just such a large area? And that's when the design I'm now going to show you was born. So to make up the arc shape, you will want a 4-inch square for the middle. You will then want a couple of strips. I'm using one strip that's 4 inches long by 2.5 inches wide. These are slightly on the generous side, but more is often better than not. And one strip of 5 inches wide, also by 2.5 inches. The strips are joined to the centre block, and it's going to end up looking something like this. Join one strip on, and I'd be inclined to press your strip open and flat, the seam open and flat on the back. Join the other one on down the other side, and again, open and flat. And it's going to end up something like that. Taking the template, place the template carefully onto the section, making very certain that the little dot we have here goes through the crossover of the seam junction. Because I want to get, because I'm a bit fussy sometimes, you know, there are occasions when I do like to have things perfect, because patchworkers can be picky. Okay, so get your little dot there. Hand on the cutter, cut round the edge. And this is going to give you a nice, neat arc. If you then take this nice, neat arc and the L-shaped section, we're going to join the two pieces together. Now, when it comes to joining them together, it pays to mark the centre of both pieces. Now, I found it was easiest to mark them by literally folding it in half and putting a small nick in there. Nothing like a little nick. And fold the other one over and again put a small nick in it. Then all we've got to do is line up nick to nick. Nothing like getting all your nicks in a row. Now, when it comes to putting them together, I will put the L-shaped section on top of the arc-shaped section. I think it makes considerably more sense than doing it the other way around. But, you know, each to his own. We've all got these set ideas. Oh, you must do it that way. The quilt police say it's got to be done that way. Put a pin in the middle. Flex it round so the straight edge is exactly lined up with the outside edge there and pin it. This is why these flower head pins are so remarkably good. Bend it round the other way, get it absolutely together there, pin it, and all you're going to do is sew it. And I know I haven't used the sewing machine so far, but this little singer here comes absolutely great because it's got a nice 1/4-inch foot with it. Now, in order to get it a little bit more together, straighten it out so the edges of the two shapes come together, and put another pin in the middle. You will find this slightly easier. Do not sew your shapes together with black thread, which I'm about to do, simply so you can see where I'm stitching. Pop it underneath the machine, and using a quarter of an inch seam allowance, you are going to sew round the edge. Now, you, of course, at home won't be standing on one foot. What I do with the pins is sew up to the pins, remove the pin, using the edge of the presser foot, just follow all the way round. Taking the pin out, do not sew over the pins, please. We don't sew over pins, do we? No, miss. All sitting there terrified at home in case I give you the death stare because you're sewing over pins. Mustn't sew over pins. Round we go, keep on going, keep on going. Take the pins out, you go to them. See, what happens if you sew over the pin is you can inadvertently take the pin down into the inside of the machine. I've seen it happen twice. I think I might have got a little nick in there, but never mind. And then when you get to the end, onto the good old thread saver, because it does save thread. When you've done it, you'll find it will be best to press your seams towards the outside edge. And this is where, if you've sewn through the little dot at the end there, you should be bang on. Oh, crikey, wasn't that good? Actually, did it. Well done, Jennifer. Doesn't always happen, but that was a good one. So having sewn round the edge there, I've now got my municipal gardens. And these can be sewn together to make a nice long row. And whether you have them like that or how you choose to arrange them is entirely and utterly up to you. So let's just go back to the quilt and look at the quilt that we've done. So we've dealt with the lake, the beach, the deep dark forest. So this is using your trimate, using your Tri-Rex template, the triangle for the middle and the triangle for here, and just on the ends are you using the other section. Then we did the cozy cottages using your half square triangles and your companion angle, and indeed the ruler and the square. Snail trails, or if you preferred, you can swap for log cabin corners on the cabin, or you could do a pineapple, or you could just have something plain. Then we came down to making this path. How you choose to arrange it is entirely and utterly up to you, but all four strips should, I hope, be all the same length. We will deal with the flowers next time I come back, because we'll do the beach, the waves, the sea, the little boats, the edging, and explain how you're going to put it together. So there you go. That is this month's section of the Quilting Classroom. Oh, well, I must show you, because we're going to get our Dean back again now.
She's beckoned me.
Beckoned,
did you see that?
Beckoned. Come. Let me pick up all the pieces.
Pick up the pieces.
Grovel on the floor at his feet.
Grovel.
You know, people
you
always ask.
You weren't the first.
People ask, what happens at the end of a show? I say, I have to clear it all up.
Absolutely.
And
clear
what's going to happen
love.
Now is all goes into the bag, I go home and agonise over it. But I must show you
agonize.
This.
What have you got?
Okay, back on the 29th,
yes,
we've got a show with different templates.
Okay.
And this is one of the new ideas I've come up with.
Well, that's pretty.
Using 45 degree diamonds and
these
triangles.
These are the sort of patterns to do your head in.
Yes.
I often say, you know, you look at it, well, I think you've seen it, then you've seen something, then you see something
that's
else.
That's because it works.
Yes,
that's
because the, if I look at that, it's that.
Yes.
And if I look at that, it's that.
Yes.
And if I look at something else, it's something
yes.
else. That's and it's like weird. It's like a kaleidoscope.
Yes,
and as a child, you used to turn it and your eyes go funny. You have to refocus, yes. you see something else.
Yeah.
That's what good patchwork should be. And that's coming next month, yes?
On 29th.
29th.
No, next month on the 28th of March, we hope.
That is next month, is it?
Yes,
me?
But this is February, 29th of Feb.
Oh, this is 29th of Feb?
Yes, because I'm back again then. You see, you've got
Blimey.
To put up me again on the 29th of February.
Oh, it'll be someone else.
No, I've got to come all this way.
Oh, no.
Yes,
woe is
but
me.
I love it.
OK, what have been your favourites in this hour? Because I haven't been listening. Fabric.
And I've just made a
the
mess.
The fabric, Jimmy, has sold out, son. Come on, son. Oh, sorry, is that the fabric gone? It's livening this up here. What should we go to? The triangles, have they sold out? This would be fun. This will be like a kung fu movie.
Oh, no, don't do that. Listen, he's very good to me, is our
Now
James.
Then, must-haves. When we started the show all that time ago, I'm sure I nodded off. Okay. And the thing is...
Oh, was I that boring?
No, I wasn't listening to you. I was doing something else. The thing is, I'm going to blame the other person. The thing is, what you've got here is another must-have, isn't
yes,
it? Yeah. Explain why.
Right, it's a must-have because these shapes are your core shapes. Okay, so that is your half-square triangles.
Correct.
That's your quarter square. Got to have them. And they do your quarter of an inch.
Lovely biscuits.
Then you get these two. And these are the two that make... Let's just have me block
Let me hold that. You hold the block.
Okay, so this does... The triangle, large triangle does... Hang on, we're fighting. That bit, and the smaller piece does that. So it's a very good shape because you can use it in a variety of different ways.
Right.
I've used it for trees, and I find this so useful because if I wanted to do this in a different size, I'd have to get out graph paper, draw it up, but I've got multi-sizes.
Lovely. There. And it doesn't just have to be the shape. It can be a tree, as Jennie said. You can
yes.
make it into something
all
else as well. And there's one more just quickly to show
and
you.
And that one makes it into makes either a row, excellent for a border, or it does make a really rather nice shape around it. If we go to look at, I say, that one,
yeah.
You can see there in the middle is your Tri-Rex. Here on the corner is your easy angle, your half square triangles. And there is what's known as the Tri-Mate. That piece and that piece come from the same template.
It's amazing, isn't it? You always look at the main shape and forget the fillers. Make sure you grab this now. And also, I hope you've been taking advantage of FlexiPay in this hour. Two payments on that one, £22.50. Now, the Easy Patchwork Bundle, which is right in front of us now, is an absolute must again. We must stay with the must-haves, because if you've got these tools, everything you've heard in the last hour will become so much easier.
Yes.
This obviously is a small piece of paper for a large square. The Easy Patchwork Template Bundle gives you a 10.5-inch easy angle acrylic template, 6.5 by 24, easy rule, the big long one. You also get in the quilting square, which I've got in my hand, which is 12.5.
Yes.
So it's actually a little bit bigger. Actually, not too bad for doing scrapbooking and stuff. You're
yes,
trying to work out a page.
Your
12-inch page, so you've got a little bit more than that,
yep.
so you can see beyond the page. Well worth having. Nice and sturdy, and tools for life there,
yes.
ladies. £25.98 saving. Is that right? £25.98
yes,
saving?
I know. Yes.
£46.70. That's incredible value.
And they are so expensive. I mean, you often go to places and these are £20. £20, £18, £19. So you are saving that amount of
there
money.
There you go. Now then. Now, next up,
right.
we've got for you the full set.
Yes.
Now,
I've lent you mine.
Oh, hang on a second. The full set of those from earlier on. We didn't have the full set with the drunk spath, etc., but we do have the full set there too, so you can see those. But something else that you're all buying, if you're starting quilting today, get the bits and pieces.
Yes.
And this is the quilting tool set with your bamboo pointer, you've got pencils in here,
yep.
pins, your favourite
yes,
pins.
My favourite pins.
You've actually got your quarter inch
bar. Well, this is so good. If you want to have a quarter inch seam, you simply put it down the edge of your fabric, hold your pencil at 45 degrees to it, and you can get right up to the edge of that and get an accurate seam. So all you've got to do is follow the line.
And what we're talking about here is exactly what Jennie just said. Accuracy is everything. You start well, you'll finish well.
Yes.
And I think exactly what we've done here. We started quite well, and we're finishing quite well.
Because well,
we're running out of time. if you'd like to get any of these items and you'd like to do what Jennie does, please go to the website. Remember, the classroom is actually downloadable online at createcraft.tv. Just go to sewing, and then from sewing go to classroom. You see Jennie's face or something. And then, you know, you'll be able to find, don't worry, Jimmy found it, so you will be able to.
And he's a man.
And he's a man.
He's
a, no, he's not. And the thing is, he's a lad.
All right, he's a lad.
He's a
yes.
lad.
So
in our minds.
He's younger than us.
Everyone's
you
younger than us, Jenny. Hang on. Yep. I'm in your camp with you. I'll stay with you, love. Now, listen, if you want to see the next one, give us a date again.
28th
of February.
29th of February, I'm
next
back with
next week.
Show. But the next classroom is, yes, is on Easter Sunday.
Easter Sunday.
Yay!
We'll be bringing eggs and everything. Don't go anywhere. Still loads more crumbs still to come with love.